half of the nodes in a heap are leaves. Why is that the case? We can see that in the following way. So a heap is a nearly complete binary tree. So let's for the moment assume it's actually a complete binary tree. So let's ignore those nodes down there. So then these are the leaves. So let's count how many nodes we have. So we have 1 in the first level, then 2, 4, 8. So 8 is the number of leaves. But in the previous levels, I have overall 7 nodes. And 7 plus 8 is 15. And 8 is indeed 15 divided by 2, rounded up. So what do we have more generally here if we have a complete binary tree? So 7 actually corresponds to the sum over 2 to the I for all those levels. And that goes up to level height minus 1. So let's call the height h, h minus 1, 2 to the I. And this is a geometric series. And that gives us 2 to the, and then h minus 1 plus 1, minus 1, which is simply 2 to the h minus 1. In contrast, the number of leaves, so per level, the number of nodes doubles. So this is simply 2 to the h. Now the number of nodes overall is 2 to the h plus 2 to the h minus 1. And 2 to the h is half of this rounded up. Now, this is for a complete binary tree, but we have a nearly complete binary tree, so we cannot ignore those nodes down there. So let's first have a look at what happens if I add those two nodes to my complete binary tree. So how does the number of nodes and how does the number of leaves change? The number of nodes goes up by 2, but the number of leaves only goes up by 1. So why is that the case? Because I add 2 leaves, but I also make a node that previously was a leaf a non-leaf. So if I count internal nodes versus leaves, then the number of internal nodes goes up by 1, and the number of leaves goes up by 1. It goes up by 2 minus 1 is 1. And this also happens if I add these two and so on. Now, if the number of nodes in the last level is odd, like in our case here, so then I have this one here, and that one I have to treat slightly differently. Because what happens here, the number of nodes goes up by 1, but the number of leaves does not go up by 1. It stays the same because this was a leaf, now is not a leaf anymore, this is a leaf. So I have plus 1 leaf, minus 1 leaf, that is 0 extra leaves. So why isn't that a problem? It's not a problem because here we started with 2 to the h, while here we started with 2 to the h minus 1. So far we always added plus 1 plus 1 to each of those sums. Now in this last and special case, I add a plus 1 here, but that just means that this minus 1 here disappears. So now the two sums are the same, so now I truly have n half. So this is the case that I have an even number of nodes and n half are leaves. This already is a complete argument. But there is also a different way of seeing this, and that is the following. So what we actually only use here is that a complete binary tree is a binary tree where every node has either 0 or 2 children. So this is already enough to get the property that half of the nodes are leaves. And why is that the case? So we can simply argue inductively. So, and as a base, we have a binary tree with only one node, and that is simply a tree that which consists of a root. And there we have n is 1, and the number of leaves is also 1, which is 1 half rounded up. Otherwise, let's have a larger binary tree with this property. Then let me take two nodes, two siblings of height 0, these two here. Look at the tree without those two. Now this should have our property that half of the nodes are leaves. But then adding those two back gives me two extra nodes, only one extra leaf because I have this plus 2 minus 1 again. So the same argument as above. And this gives us again this n half in a somewhat more general setting. And then for the heaps, I still have to handle this last node. And that's why the number of leaves in a heap is n half.